How's it going, everybody? John MacLennan here, and in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to play Evil Is Going On by Howlin Wolf on guitar. This song has an incredible groove to it, and we're going to use just a little three-note lick and combine that together with the chord progression of a 12-bar blues in the key of G. But before we get started, I want to hook you up with something right away. I've got a free blues training series that you can get at the first link in the description, and you're going to get some essential blues guitar techniques and concepts that come with tabs, and all of the stuff is multiple camered and really high quality videos that are not on YouTube. So check that out as my gift to you. And with that said, let's break this song down. Let's break down how to play Evil as recorded by Howlin Wolf on guitar. This song is another 12-bar blues in the key of G, and it's going to demonstrate a really cool way of playing a riff and combining that within the rhythm guitar part. So I'll play it for you one time, and then let's break it down. One, two, three. So we're going to start off on the 5th fret of the 5th string, and we're going to play 5, and then go to the 4th string on the 3rd fret, and then up to 5. So that's a little pickup. We count 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and then we go to our G7 chord, and you could play this a number of ways. I'll show you the way that I play it. I play a G7 here. I put my thumb on the 3rd fret of the 6th string. Then I lay my first finger flat and do a bar from the 4th string down to the 1st string. So I'm barring all those notes, but then I'm gonna put my 2nd finger there on the 4th fret of the 3rd string to make a G7 chord. But I want that G note on top. Now, Joe Bonamassa, when he plays this, he just goes, and he just plays an octave there, which is another way you could do it, or putting the G7 chord down. You could also just play the top notes if that's too hard. Or you could play like a G major like this. All of those are options. I just like this big sound. So we're gonna do that 4 times. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 2 and. Now here, when I play this G7, I'm going, hitting the downbeat with a down strum, but then the and of 2, I'm playing another down strum. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and then I restart the riff. So it starts with the pickup, 3 and 4, and then 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and. And those chords are, I'm hitting them and then just muting. So they're just like a hit and then you get off. So let's try it 4 times. 1 and 2 and 3. Then we're gonna go to what we call our 4 chord. And I'm gonna use this C9, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, starting with the 5th string. Now here, I'm gonna keep the same riff. This time go to the C9 though. So 2 times on the C9 and then 2 times back on G. Now, leading into the turnaround, we're gonna change it up, but before we do that, let me play the first 8 bars as one piece so you can hear that. 1 and 2 and 3. Now, just to keep in mind, I am using all down picks and down strums. Now, when we go to the last four bars, which is our blues turnaround, we're gonna go up to the five chord, down to the four, and then one, then we're gonna play this little turnaround lick. So that's gonna sound like this. So I changed up the riff. Instead of going, I'm going. So I'm leading us into that five chord. So that's fifth fret on the fifth string, third fret on the fourth string, back to fifth fret on the fifth string. Then D9, same as C9, just up two frets. And then here, sometimes you'll hear that little variation. So again, you could go back to the first riff if you want, or you'll hear this variation sometimes as well on the Howlin Wolf recording. So that's going down one string. So now we're gonna start on the fourth string and play five, and then hammer 3 to 5 on the third string, back to three, C9, and then back to the original riff. Then we're gonna cut this riff short. We'll play the G once, and walk up to a D7 chord. This is a very common blues figure. Right, so we're gonna play 3, 4, and then we'll put down, it's like a D9 chord, but I'm just gonna play three notes of it, so it's actually a D7. It's what I call a shell chord. 5, 4, 5, starting with the fifth string. So the turnaround here. What a great riff. So let's play the whole thing. We're gonna play all 12 bars. Get ready, and I'll count you in. 1, 2, 3. Fun practicing Evil by Howlin Wolf on guitar. I hope you got some value out of today's video. I would recommend playing this song along with the recording to help you get the feel. And before you go, don't forget to get free access to my blues training series at the link below. Again, this is going to show you some essential blues guitar concepts and give you some tabs with some videos that are not on YouTube. So check that out as my gift to you. As always, leave any song requests in the comments below. Would love to hear what you all want to see next on the channel. Thanks so much for your support, and until next time.